Hello everybody, Mike Marini here, driver of the number 42 Toyota Camry out of True North Racing. I just wanted to check in and say thanks to all the fans and supporters of the series. We really do appreciate you guys watching. Hopefully we're putting on a good show for you guys, and hopefully we continue to do that. Also, I've been putting in a lot of time testing, trying to find that little bit of extra speed, really trying to get the 13 and the 42 into victory lane. I know we're talking to teammate Kevin Daigle, sitting back in 11th. He's not too happy. He's been having a little bit of bad luck lately, and hopefully that'll change. I'm okay with my finishes I've been having. I'm just not satisfied. I won't be satisfied until I'm winning races and leading the points. But hopefully I can start that tonight at Chicagoland Speedway, one of the trickier mile and a halves. D-shaped oval. You're going to be fighting for the bottom here. It is the fastest way around. There is multiple grooves. You're also going to want to watch the entry to pit road. It's a really tricky one. You want to watch you don't spin out or get a speeding penalty. Hopefully I'm not one of those cars. You're also going to want to watch out for lap down cars and anybody spinning on the track. Also strategy. Strategy is going to be a really big key in tonight's race. Hopefully I pick my strategy right, and hopefully I talk to you guys in victory lane at the end of the night. And again, stay safe everybody. And again, thanks for watching.
While we have a moment, we will take a quick run through the top 10 our qualifying. And on the poll here tonight will be number 23, Chevy Caro of Ryan Gibson out of Morgantown, West Virginia. And Gibson has certainly proven himself to be a threat over the course of the season. And joining him on the front row will be the number 9 car of Jacob Nelson, another Chevy Camaro out of Clarksville, Tennessee. And on row 2, we have the number 41 car of Jose Mercado out of Kissimmee, Florida, behind the wheel of the Mustang. All right, ladies and gentlemen, we are going to join this one live in progress here. This is the Factory Downtown 200, the seventh race of the Canadian eMotorsports Series regular season. And without further ado, let's head to the virtual Chicagoland Speedway here, where we will find our pole sitter, the number 23 car of Ryan Gibson out of Morgantown, West Virginia. He's in the lead at the moment, and he is about halfway through stage one here. So the way things are going to work tonight, we're going to have three stages the way we have the last few times out. The first couple stages will be 40 laps each, and then the final stage will be 54 laps for a total of 134 on this 1.5 mile tri-oval. And there you see Gibson putting a lap on Rafael de los Santos, it looks like. And we will do our best to get things up to date here for you as quickly as possible. In a few weeks, we'll be on NASCAR Heat 5, where we'll conveniently have a leaderboard and lap counter to make things a lot easier to see for our audience, and conversely, a lot easier for us to follow here at Race Control as well, as you see Gibson crossing the start-finish line there once more. And again, we're just going to try and quickly reset things here, but as we see Gibson coming into the turn, we're going to hop on board with the guy who was on the front row with him, the number 9 of Jacob Nelson out of Clarksville, Tennessee. He won the Holland College 250 to begin the season, so he's had his Canadian eMotorsports Series playoff spot locked up for a while. And yeah, Nelson's been driving really well to begin this season, tied for second in the points with Scott Bailey, last week's winner. And we see Nelson, it looks like he's coming up onto either some lap traffic or a couple of guys who might have passed him here in the early going. But for now, we will instead hop on board with got just a couple of cars ahead of him, the number 41 of Jose Mercado. He had qualified in third, the Ford Mustang out of Kissimmee, Florida. And Mercado's comfortably in the top 16 here as well as we get a really quick top five. And in fact, we're just kind of on the periphery there. Mercado running fourth. Gibson still your leader, having started on pole. The number 33 of Jason Maluchnik in the Three Rivers Racing entry out of Pittsburgh, Pennsylvania, sponsored by Rocky's Hot Sauce, is second. Hurricane Z Motorsports entry, Corbin McCauley in the number 17 Ford Mustang right ahead is in third. And then you see the battle for fourth and fifth right here between the aforementioned Mercado and Darcy Ford, the man with two victories this season and the man who currently tops the driver's standings. And we just heard it within our group Discord chat here. You're going to have the number 64, Darcy Ford, going into the pits. And indeed, there he goes. So Darcy Ford will bow out early here. He's on lap number 24. And so with Mercado heavily pursuing, McCauley here for third. We'll stick with this battle just for a moment. We'll see if Mercado can get the position. And Mercado's got the inside line, and there he is. He's stuck it for third place. So nice move there from Mercado to jump into the top three and indeed get back to his qualifying position as he and the man he just passed, Corbin McCauley, go into the pits, Jacob Nelson following them. So this looks like the first round of pit stops here, about 25 laps into this one. And we see Darcy Ford coming out of the pits here real quick. So instead, we will jump on board with Jason Maluchnik, who started sixth, but he's just coming out of the pits. You see Ryan Gibson, he pits from the lead as well. And Maluchnik making his way out. We'll do our best to get a reset here as we're now on board with the number 4 of Scott Bailey, last week's winner. He qualified sixth in that NBR Motorsports Chevy Camaro. And Bailey's been very consistent over the course of the season here. But a bit of a slow start for him here tonight. Bailey currently running in 16th place. Although it looks like he may have just come out of the pits. So, again, we're just looking to get a bit of a reset here as we go through the field. So next up, we are going to go to his, well, we're going to stay right behind him, actually. The NBR Motorsports second entry, the number 88 of Shane Cannon. Chevy Camaro out of Cambridge, Ontario. And again, Cannon qualified seventh here this evening. And his victory came a few weeks ago. So he is also in the Canadian New Motorsports Series playoffs already. So good start to the season for NBR Motorsports. And now we're going to go on board with the brand new paint scheme, belonging to the number 21 of Chad Hyder out of Dayton, Ohio. Driving for Buckeye Performance E Motorsports out of Dayton, Ohio. And Hyder, he's currently running in 19th, but that might be, again, just the field shuffling through on pit stops here in the early going. And as we see Hyder coming up to the start-finish line, we're now going to hop on board with the guy we talked to pre-race. Hopefully we'll be able to air that interview a little bit later, maybe in one of our cautions. Anyway, it's the number 42 of Mike Marini. He qualified in 9th. The True North Racing Toyota Camry out of Thunder Bay, Ontario. And we've talked about it a couple of times over the weeks here, but Marini has certainly had an abundance of speed when he needs it, especially in qualifying, but it just hasn't necessarily translated to race results the way he or his teammate Kevin Daigle in the second True North Racing entry would like. And then we are going to hop on board with the number 17 of Corbin McCauley. We saw him earlier in the race battling for third and fourth place with the likes of Jose Mercado and Darcy Ford. And that Hurricane Z Motorsports entry is running pretty well here in the early going. And it looks like he's got last week's winner Scott Bailey hanging around behind him. There's they get onto the back straightaway. And McCauley currently running in 7th place here, so a good start here for the young Charlottetown Prince Edward Island driver, sponsored by Logitech Gaming. Leon's, Fix Auto Charlottetown, and D. Alex McDonald Ford. And the way things have shaken out in the early going here with pit stops, our current leader is the commissioner himself, Daniel Cudmore, in the number 2 Ford Mustang out of Stanchel, Prince Edward Island. So a couple of Hurricane Z Motorsports entries in the top 10 here to begin. And let's go on board here now with the second Three Rivers Racing entry of Joey Squatriglia, the number 15 out of Bridgeville, Pennsylvania. Sponsored by Pittsburgh Insulation and Property Development. And we're doing our best to get a position check on Squatriglia here. He's got his teammate there, Jason Maluknik, right next to him. And Squatriglia currently down the field a little bit. He's in 23rd place after having qualified in 11th. And we just see Daniel Cudmore coming into the pits here. Full disclosure for our fans, he's driving in the Canadian eMotorsports Series Race Control Studio here with us. And now we're going to jump to the number 67 of Waylon Brown as he just crossed the start-finish line. He was victorious at the Cook Insurance Group 200, our second race of the regular season. So he's had his playoff spot locked up for a little bit. 67 Chevy Camaro out of Grand Prairie, Alberta. Looks like Brown may have sustained a little bit of front-end damage there if you take a look at the hood right offhand. And we'll do our best to catch up with Waylon here in a little bit as he goes low across the start-finish line once again. So we're now going to go on board with the number 6 of Trevor Kinsey out of Midland, Michigan. He's the man who currently holds the final playoff spot here for the moment, currently 16th in the standings. Qualified 13th this evening and currently running in 8th. So decent start here for Kinsey in this first stage as we've got 6 laps remaining. And as Kinsey heads into turn 1 to begin another lap, we're going to go on board now with the number 38 Toyota Camry of Jace Swint of Phoenix City, Alabama. And again, we're doing our best to get a Doing our best to get a position check here on Swint as he comes onto the front straightaway. And Swint is currently running in 10th place here by the looks of things. So good start here for the Phenix City, Alabama native. And he's certainly someone that could be looked at as a bit of a mover going forward. So we are now going to hop on board with the number 8 car of Sterling Ford. Turned in probably his best qualifying effort of the season to this point. So he would have qualified around the middle of the field. I believe 15th is his qualifying position. And again, we'll do our best to catch up with Sterling behind the wheel of that number 8 Chevy Camaro sponsored by Blue Heron Construction whenever we come back around to him. But for now, we'll go on board with the number 10 of Jason Butler out of London, Ontario, sponsored by the Beard Struggle and Rampage Coffee Company, that 519 eSports Ford Mustang. We're just going to see Butler cross the line here once again. We're coming down to the final couple laps of this first stage here. And now we're going to get on board with the number 13 of Kevin Daigle, that second True North Racing entry. Mike Marini kind of alluded to it in his pre-race interview. He and Daigle haven't necessarily been happy with their finishes to this point in the season, but they're the kind of guys who can certainly find speed when needed. And Daigle, he's still in the top 16 overall, that second True North Racing Camry out of Thunder Bay, Ontario. And for now, oh, it looks like contact in the back. It looks like Darcy Ford got into the wall, came down into the number 87 of Justin Deloach. Not quite sure what happened. We just kind of saw it in the background. But indeed, just a little bit of contact. Ford had been running toward the front of the field, so we'll see how that kind of affects him going forward. But for now, we're going to get on board with the number 81 car of Kevin Fenech. Again, the guy with the most points in the series without a victory to this point. And the Toronto, Ontario native, sponsored by Primary Engines, Inc. He tries to make a move on the number 77 of Eric Greer out of Utica, Kentucky, and he goes low on him and sticks it. As we come to the end of the first stage here, we will get a quick reset here of our field. And our top 10 after stage one, Ryan Gibson is in the lead. Jose Mercado second, Darcy Ford was third, Corbin McCauley fourth, Scott Bailey fifth, Shane Cannon sixth, so the two NBR Motorsports guys together, Jacob Nelson seventh, Trevor Kinsey eighth, Mike Marini ninth, and in 10th place, just give me a moment to look, didn't quite catch it prior to going into the pit lane, but in 10th place was Jace Swint in that Toyota Camry out of Phenix City, Alabama. So we will be starting stage two here momentarily. And as a result, we're back up to the front of the field where we see Ryan Gibson in the lead, ready to take the green flag to begin stage two. Mercado on the outside. And we are green once again. Stage two is underway. And Gibson will lead them into turn one here. He's got Mercado on the outside. Kevin Fenech kind of worming his way in there. Not sure if that's for position or perhaps a lapped vehicle, as Mercado giving Gibson a bit of a push forward. Those two separating themselves here in the early going. 37 laps in this second stage here. And Gibson's going to go down low using every ounce of track possible to hang on to the lead. But looks like Gibson's gone high this time around, and Mercado might get him down low. And I thought I saw some contact in the back there, but it looks like we're okay for the time being. But as a result, Gibson gets pushed a little bit high. Your new leader is the number 41 of Jose Mercado, the Ford Mustang out of Kissimmee, Florida. And you got a few guys taking that really low line on the apron, coming through the start-finish straight. And you've got some familiar faces in the top five. Certainly you've got both NBR Motorsports Camaros there. Another one belonging to tonight's pole sitter, Ryan Gibson. Your leader right now is the number 64 of Darcy Ford in that Ford Mustang. He of two victories already this season. And Jose Mercado rounds out that top five, but currently in second place as we get a quick reset here on lap four of this second stage. And we're going to try and hop around a little bit here. We're now on board with the number nine of Jacob Nelson. He's a little bit further down the field, having started in second. Looks like he's just kind of on the periphery of the top 10. Eyeballing it, we're going to say right in 10th place right now is Jacob Nelson. He's got Jason Maluchnik right ahead of him in that number 33 Three Rivers Racing car. And he's going to give Maluchnik a bit of a push forward to try and help them both out. And as they go into turn one, we are going to hop on board now with the man who had been the race leader at one point, the number 41 of Jose Mercado. And he's going down low here on Darcy Ford. This may be for the lead here. We're back up at the front of the field. And Mercado runs low, going through the start-finish line to begin lap six of this second stage. And Mercado's certainly shown himself to be fast at these kinds of tracks, both in the preseason and the regular season. And Mercado comfortably in the top 16 in points right now, but I'm sure he would love a victory to formally secure his playoff spot here, but lots of laps to run here tonight. So we'll see how various strategies pan out here. And we're going to stay with this lead group here for a little bit as we hop on board with the number 64 of Darcy Ford right in the middle of it in third. And Ford, it looks like Gibson might have gotten caught a little bit high. Bailey's going to push Ford forward. And the other NBR Motorsports vehicle of Shane Cannon, he's looking to help out a little bit as well. Ford goes high. But he's able to hold his line and the lead here as they go into lap eight of this second stage. And Mercado's got him down low here. He may try to take the lead here once again. These top five have certainly separated themselves in the early going of this second stage here as they go into turn three. And Mercado's still your leader. Perhaps some communication there, excuse me, between Mercado and Darcy Ford, potentially working together here to keep the NBR Motorsports vehicles from getting by. The Green Machines, I believe they were referred to here from our Discord chat, and we'll certainly patch that in here in a little bit, but not just yet. And Ford just content to stick behind Mercado here for a little bit, although it looks like Bailey may try and apply some pressure. And as I say that, Ford's going to go a little high, and Scott Bailey may sneak through and get the position. Just a matter of seeing whether or not Shane Cannon will follow him. And indeed, it looks like that's what may happen here, is they'll come into turn three on the inside. Thought Cannon might try and make it a three-wide situation there, but he's just going to follow his teammate Bailey on the lower line. And Ford is content to stay high there for a little bit. It looks like just about cut off Ryan Gibson there in fifth. But for now, we will hop over to the number 33 car of Jason Maluchnik, that Three Rivers Racing Chevy Camaro at Pittsburgh, Pennsylvania. Maluchnik turned in a really solid qualifying effort, having qualified in fifth. And we're just going to do our best to get a position check for that Camaro here, just to make sure. And looks like Maluchnik is kind of on the periphery of that top 10, because I see Waylon Brown, Trevor Kinsey ahead of him, so That's where they've typically been running throughout the course of the race. Again, this will be a lot easier to track in a few weeks when we have NASCAR Heat 5, so stay tuned for that. And instead, we are now going to go to, well, back to the front of the field, actually, for the number four of Scott Bailey, who is, in fact, your race leader, I do believe. Three-wide situation there. Bailey, Mercado, Ford, and Cannon might try and get in on the act from fourth place as well. But for now, Scott Bailey is your race leader. And Bailey's able to hang on here. Now the question will be whether or not Shane Cannon can get by both Mercado and Ford to make it an NBR 1-2. We certainly saw that at Atlanta a few weeks ago when Cannon clinched his Canadian e-Motorsports Series playoff spot. And Bailey hanging on. Here he's got Mercado right on the back bumper. It looks like Cannon's gotten into third. So just one lone Jose Mercado separating NBR Motorsports from a 1-2 here at about the midway point of not only this stage, but getting close to the midway point of the race as well. Now we are going to, well, we're actually going to stay with this lead pack here. It's the number 88, Shane Cannon, that we're with, and we see him trying to make the move on the outside line on Mercado for second. And Cannon continuing to push Bailey forward while potentially getting a bit of a draft of his own here. And a little bit of minimal contact, I should say, between Cannon and Mercado there. Nothing too overly harmful. And what a three-wide situation. We've got the two NBRs up high. Jose Mercado going down low. This lead group of five has really done a good job of separating itself from the rest of the field here in this second stage. And we're going to give this lead pack a little bit of a break here, but we're hoping to come back to them by the end of the stage. But for now, we are with the number 21 of Chad Hyder, who qualified 8th. Again, that's a new look for Hyder, who's currently in 13th place out of Dayton, Ohio. That Buckeye Performance e-Motorsports Ford Mustang. And again, he's sponsored by the YouTube channel DHAM I Am. And Hyder comes through to complete the lap. And we're now going to go on board with Mike Marini, who was in 9th. It looks like we just had Lee Campbell go through the grass there ahead of him. And we just see Marini coming through the start-finish area. I'm not sure if he had just pitted or couldn't quite get a visual of what was going on. But for now, it looks like Marini's got some clear track all the way around him here, at least for a little bit. So we're going to go on board now with the number 17 Hurricane D Motorsports Ford Mustang of Corbin McCauley out of Charlottetown PEI. And McCauley currently on the back straight there. Looks like that's Darcy Ford catching him from behind. So this could be a situation where McCauley is either getting lapped or... And McCauley currently running in third place here as we are getting updates from the Discord group chat. I think we're getting into another pit stop window here as a result. And our suspicions have been confirmed here. The field is starting to shuffle a little bit. And we see a train of cars here. We just got word that Jason Butler was assessed a time penalty for speeding as well in the pit lane. The number 10 Mustang out of London, Ontario. And as we see McCauley heading into the pits, there's Butler in the pit lane. We just passed him. And we see Joey Squatriglia coming into the pit lane, that second Three Rivers Racing car, as we see Butler coming out, having served his penalty now. And now we're going to get on track here with our Auto Club winner, Waylon Brown, out of Grand Prairie, Alberta. And ooh, things got a little bit dicey there between Brown and Hyder. Hyder forced a little bit high, but Jacob Nelson might try and take advantage here. It's a three wide into turn one. And Brown hangs on to the position here for the time being, but he's got Nelson on the outside. We'll see if Brown squeezes out his fellow Camaro here as they go into turn three. And as Nelson tries to find a way around him, they cross the start-finish line here once again. And we're now on board with the number six of Trevor Kinsey out of Midland, Michigan. And Kinsey hanging on to the back straightaway. Again, he had qualified 13th here this evening, and he's a guy who's certainly watching his spot on the bubble here, especially as we get a little bit closer to the halfway point of the regular season. And for the moment, Kinsey running in 10th place. And confirmation from Mr. Kinsey himself in the Discord chat that he is currently running in 10th place. So good communication all the way around here as we'll go on board with the number 38 of Jay Swint. He was 10th after stage one. The Phoenix City, Alabama native in that number 38 Toyota Camry. And again, we're in a bit of a pit window here coming toward the end of it, so we're still kind of cycling our way through the field. So some of these positions may not hold up for a real long time here as we now hop on board with the number eight of Sterling Ford. Qualified 15th for this race. Again, we're just trying to get a position check on Ford this time around, the Harrington PEI native. All right, and as he goes on to the back straightaway, we will now go on board with the number 10 of Jason Butler, who we saw serving his time penalty for speeding in the pit lane. And as a result, Butler has fallen down the field a little bit, currently in 22nd place here, that Mustang out of London, Ontario. 519 Esports is his team. Rampage Coffee Company and the Beard Struggle are his sponsors. And this time around, we're going to come on board with the number 13 Toyota Camry of Kevin Daigle, who's running in 15th place. And he's got Scott Bailey there with him. Again, Daigle is also in the playoffs if the season were to end today. But as Marini alluded to in their pre-race interview, they would certainly like to see their results improve a little bit, as we're now going to go on board with the number 81 of Kevin Fenwick. He's sustained some early damage here. And again, you see that damage. It's certainly damaged as a result by the sounds of things. Currently running in 23rd place. Not really where we're accustomed to seeing the number 81 Chevy Camaro. And now we're going to get on board with the number 47 Atlantic Motorsports entry of Michael Robinson, the Ford Mustang out of Harrington, Prince Edward Island, running in 18th place. And, you know, Robinson, he's the guy that was looking forward to a solid results here tonight, running about middle of the pack. He's a guy who'd certainly love to get a top 10 here this evening to boost his playoff chances as guys start to think about that a little bit more. And it looks like we've got a bit of a wreck in turn three. We'll have to see if we come up on it with Robinson here. Robinson with Michael Dimitroff right on the back of him. And indeed, we see Sterling Ford got turned around somehow. And not 100% sure what happened there with Ford, whether there was another vehicle involved. But nevertheless, there was contact. Ford was facing the wrong way. And, you know, we'll have to see if he can recover the car in the second half of the race as we go on board now with the number 09 of Jason Lobby out of Coon Rapids, Minnesota, sponsored by WeatherSafe Restoration, and he's running in 15th place, so solid outing here from Lobby so far. Again, we'll have to see if pit stops are still kind of cycling through here, so the order may not be where we thought it was toward the end of this stage, I should say. And as Lobby gets down the back straightaway, we're going to see Bruce Webb try and overtake him here. Going to say that's for 15th place. Webb, the Middle Sackville, Nova Scotia native, and that Toyota Camry sponsored by Uncommon Spirit Jewelry Company. And it looks like Webb made the move here. So nice move from the number 63. It looks like he's sustained some damage. And again, we're doing our best to get position checks from our drivers here. But again, we see Webb was involved in some early shenanigans, shall we say. But as we continue our cycle through the field, we're now on board with the number 19 Hurricane Z Motorsports car of Michael Dimitroff. At last check, he was running toward the back of the pack. And Dimitroff running in 29th, so that's a bit of a jump forward for him. At last check, he had been 31st, so he improved a couple of positions here. And the guys are having fun here in the Discord chat. We'll get to them in the final stage because we certainly want you to be able to hear some of this as we go on board with the number 44 of Dalton Simpson. Bit of a hometown track for him here, actually, the Monmouth, Illinois native in that Chevy Camaro. And we're just going to hang on here for another second. And as they come into turns 3 and 4, we're going to go on board now with the number 60, Ali Campbell, out of Ballston Spa, New York, that Ford Mustang. And Campbell currently running in 24th place here at the moment. And as he comes into turns 3 and 4, we're going to go on board with the commish, Dan Cudmore, running in 21st place. And we're going to see him complete another lap here. We're getting toward the final lap or two of this second stage here. We're going to do our best to get a reset here, or we'll get our results here soon enough, as we're now on board with the number 18 of Blake Bernard. Sponsored by Summerside Toyota and Lone Oak Brewery. And we're just going to hang with Bernard on this back straightaway moment. And now we're with Mark Cox, the number 98 Hurricane Z Motorsports entry out of Cornwall, Prince Edward Island. Jose Mercado is still your leader. And we're just going to keep cycling here. Jason McCrory, he had a good finish last week, finishing fourth to get into the top 16 in points right now. But it looks like he's a little bit further down the field here for the time being. So we're going to keep going. It looks like Justin Deloach may have had a mechanical failure, if one is to guess. And now we're going on board with Eric Greer out of Utica, Kentucky. And indeed, we are now at the end of the second stage here. So we're going to do our best to get around to the front of the field to get you your results or progress through the end of stage two. And at this point, we're just getting our results here. So after stage two, Jose Mercado leads, Ryan Gibson is second, Corbin McCauley third in the number 17 Hurricane Z Motorsports Mustang out of Charlottetown PEI. Fourth is Jacob Nelson, the number 9 out of Clarksville, Tennessee. And rounding out the top 5, there he is, the number 67, Waylon Brown out of Grand Prairie, Alberta. And this is our final scheduled caution of the evening here. We'll be right back here with the start of our third and final stage, so don't go anywhere. And here we are, we've got Mercado bunching up the field here. We see him right ahead of Ryan Gibson, who we're on board with. We have now officially started the third and final stage. And it's a bit of a rough start here as we see Jacob Nelson go high into the wall. They had gone three wide, Gibson, McCauley, and Nelson. And it's tight. And we're going to be right back here. Oh, man, it looks like we're seeing some wrecks here. We'll have to figure out our technical difficulties here. We'll be right back. Looks like we're back up and running here. We're doing our best to get a handle of these technical difficulties here as we're still on board with Ryan Gibson. Unfortunately, we froze just as a wreck was happening on the front straight. It sounded like Corbin McCauley was involved in that Hurricane Z Motorsports number 17 by the sounds of it. And we're sticking on board with Ryan Gibson at the moment, running in second place. And you see Jose Mercado comfortably in the lead here to start this third and final stage ahead of him. And right before we froze, we saw Jacob Nelson tag the wall here. We're now on board with the number 9 Chevy Camaro to Clarksville, Tennessee. Again, he'd gotten three wide with Gibson and Corbin McCauley to start the third stage, and you see the battle scars from it as a result. Going to see Nelson come through here. He's going to come across the start-finish line right about now. And now we are going to hop on board with our leader, Jose Mercado, Kissimmee, Florida native, in that number 41 Ford Mustang. And he's gotten some early separation here between himself and his would-be challengers as we're coming up on 47 laps remaining in this one. And you see, it looks like Mercado's got a really good car here in this early parts of the third stage. And we saw him pull away like this in the... Michigan pre-race as well. And while we're with Mercado, we're just going to take a very quick break, and we will be back shortly. And we're back. We are on board still with Jose Mercado, the race leader at last check. It looks like he's still got the gap there over Ryan Gibson. So Gibson, one of the NBR Motorsports entries, and Jason Maluchnik, the number 33 in the Chevy Camaro out of Pittsburgh, Pennsylvania. And for now, we are going to hop on board with the number 64 of Darcy Ford. Atlantic Motorsports Ford Mustang, sponsored by Suck It Up Septa, currently running in 14th place. Like a man with two victories so far this season, looking to make a move on Kinsey down low. And we're going to do our best to make our way through the field here in this third and final stage. So we're going to keep going here. We're now on board with the number 33 of Jason Maluchnik, running in fifth place by the looks of things. And again, it looks like Maluchnik is running toward the front of the field. I see Gibson ahead of him. So it looks like we're going to eyeball it as fourth place here for Maluchnik, hanging back in that second group there as Mercado continues to pull away. And we're going to stay with that group here as we're with the number four of Scott Bailey, last week's winner. And indeed, for Scott Bailey is in third place in that number four Chevy Camaro, all over the back of Ryan Gibson in the 23. And Bailey certainly appears to be racing with more confidence. Not that he didn't have a lot before. He was certainly a premier driver to this point in the season. But after the win last week, he's certainly, you know, showcasing that that wasn't a fluke either with this effective run so far. And we're going to get on board now with the number 88 car of Shane Cannon, the second NBR Motorsports entry out of Cambridge, Ontario. Another Chevy Camaro here. Again, Cannon clinched his position in the playoffs with his victory at Atlanta. And Cannon, yeah, there he is. He's running in fifth place. A little bit of distance between himself and the group ahead of him. As Cannon gets into turn one here, we're now going to go on board with the number 21 of Chad Hyder. Looks like Hyder sustained a bit of damage. And Hyder's currently running in 25th place. He's a couple of laps down in this one. You see he's got some front end damage as well. You see him running alongside Waylon Brown there. He's had a bit of front-end damage as well, as has Corbin McCauley ahead of him. But for now, we're going to jump over to the number 42 of Mike Marini in the True North Racing Toyota Camry out of Thunder Bay, Ontario. And he had qualified in ninth. We'll have to see if that's where he still is. I'm getting the word that he is still in ninth. Just see him across the start-finish line here before we jump on board with, well, we're going to go back to the number 17, I guess, of Corbin McCauley. We saw him a moment ago. He had qualified in 10th place. And we're just going to get an update. Or we're going to try and get an update, I should say. Going to watch McCauley come through the turn here, and then we will go on board with the number 15 of Joey Squatriglia, who had qualified in 11th. And guys are certainly staying more focused in this third and final stage. And we're just getting his position check here, where he's currently in 14th place. So roughly middle of the pack here for Squitraglia in the second Three Rivers Racing entry. We've got Jason Malucnik ahead there in the top five, so this could be a good night for Three Rivers. As we're approaching 35 laps remaining in this one, 33 laps to be specific. I'm just getting the count here now. As we're now on board with the number 67, a Whalen Brown, Grand Prairie, Alberta. And again, we see Brown had sustained some damage there in the early going. And Brown currently running in 16th place at the moment. So another middle of the pack run here for Brown. But again, he did his damage in the early part of the season. And we're going to jump up to the number 6 Ford Mustang of Trevor Kinsey here. Running in 13th place. Indeed, there he is right in front of Squitraglia, who we were just with a moment ago. And again, you know, Kinsey would love to grab a top 10 here just to try and get a few more points to improve his standing within the driver's standings at the moment, because he's got that 16th and final spot right now. And now we're going to go on board with the number 38 of Jace Swint, Toyota Camry out of Phoenix City, Alabama. And we may try and get a position check on him. And we're just gonna hang with him into the turn. And at this point, we're now gonna go on board with the number 8 of Sterling Ford, hoping that's not a mechanical failure for him, but it looks like that might be the case. So we're gonna keep moving. And we're gonna go on board with the number 10 of Jason Butler. If you recall, we just saw him go through the grass. And if you recall, he took a speed penalty in the second stage, speeding in the pit lane. And at that time, he had been in the 20s. And Butler currently running in 19th place here. So it looks like Butler is doing his best to try and salvage a decent finish here in that Ford Mustang out of London, Ontario. And as Butler continues his run here, we're going to go on board with the number 13 of Kevin Daigle, as it looks like he's just gone in. We saw someone else go into the pits, but Daigle's running in 7th. So, decent run here for that second True North Racing entry. And we're just going to hang around here with Daigle on the back straight for another moment. And Daigle turning in a respectable finish here as we marvel at some of the game's wonders here on our screen in the studio as we go on board now with the number 81 of Kevin Fenwick. I think that is a scheduled pit stop for him. We see a couple of cars in. And there's Fenwick getting out of pit lane. We see Dan Cudmore coming into pit lane right behind him. Looks like Cudmore is leaving pit lane at the same time. And now we're on board with Michael Robinson, who's in the pit lane. So we'll do our best to get a reset of the picture here. This will probably be the final pit stop for our drivers here this evening. Maybe one more, we'll have to see. But for now, we're going to get on board with the 09 of Jason Lobby, who's just coming out of pit lane. The Coon Rapids, Minnesota native, sponsored by WeatherSafe Restoration. And yeah, as you saw, we were definitely going through another round of pit stops, so we'll do our best to kind of reset things for you here in the very near future. And as we are on board with Lobby here for now, he had been running around the middle of the pack the last time we checked on him, so if he could turn in a decent result, that might boost his chances and maybe give him a little spark going into the second half of the regular season as that's coming up. And now we are going to hop on board with the number 63 of Bruce Webb, the Toyota Camry out of Middle Sackville, Nova Scotia, but we may not stay with him long as he's heading into pit lane. Webb, it looks like he might have stayed out a lap or two longer in that Uncommon Spirit Jewelry Company Camry here. We'll have to see what's going on here with our next on board, the number 98, or not yet. We're getting word that the number 98 of Mark Cox may have experienced some mechanical failures here, but we're on board now with the number 19 of Michael Dimitrov. He's currently running in 26th place. And Dimitrov, he's the guy who, he's absolutely having fun with this. He's having a blast with the Canadian eMotorsports Series, and we hope you're enjoying watching as well. And now we're going to get on board with the number 44, Dalton Simpson, that Chevy Camaro to Monmouth, Illinois. Effectively, once again, a hometown race for Simpson, not too far away from Chicago. Simpson running a respectable 12th place here, but again, we'll have to see how pit stops will shake out the field here for this last run. And Simpson has Quattriglia on the back of him there, so that could be a battle for position. And we're going to stay with this battle until the start-finish line. We'll see if Squatriglia can get around Simpson. And as they come through the start-finish line, it looked like Squatriglia was trying to get down low on him. But Simpson's able to hold the place, and so we'll hop on board with the number 60 of Lee Campbell out of Balsam Spa, New York, behind the wheel of the Ford Mustang. And Campbell, he's on the outside looking in the driver's standings right now, currently tied for 17th on 117 points. So you know Campbell would love to string together a couple of good finishes to try and vie for one of those last couple spots. Stick with Campbell as he drives with Jason McCrory there on his inside line. And as they come through turn one, we're now with the commission himself, Dan Cudmore, who's running in 20th place. And we're coming up on about 20 laps to go here in this one. And Cudmore, it looks like he just got lapped again by our race leader, Jose Mercado. So there's a timely update. Thank you, Commissioner. And Mercado just continuing to slice through the field ahead of Cudmore. Scott Bailey running in second. You just see them getting by Cudmore here, and it looks like Gibson may follow the trend here. And we're now on board with Blake Bernard just exiting the pit lane in that Lone Oak Brewing Summerside Toyota Camry, I suppose. If you're sponsored by Summerside Toyota, you better be driving a Camry, I suppose. And as Bernard exits the pit lane, we're gonna head back out on track, or we're not heading on track. We're with the unfortunately disconnected Mark Cox in the number 98 Hurricane Z Motorsports Ford Mustang. And now we're going to check in with the number 66 of Jason McCrory, the number 66, I said, out of Cornwall, Prince Edward Island, Chevy Camaro. And it looks like he has Jason Maluchnik there right behind him. I'm not sure if that's for position or Maluchnik maybe trying to put him a lap down. We're just doing our best to get a position check here. And we'll just watch this one through the start-finish line here as we're inside 20 laps to go. And there he goes, and now we'll go to the 87 of Justin Deloach. That's another mechanical issue, I do believe. And so we're going to skip ahead to the number 77 of Eric Greer out of Utica, Kentucky. Sponsored by Kelly Ray's Country Cafe, Cobra Cuts, and we'll get his last couple sponsors here when they come up on the screen. I believe Premier Sanitation is another one, and Pete Morris Trucking is the other. There we go. We've got all our sponsor reads for you, Mr. Greer. And we're just going to stick with Greer here for another moment or two. I think this might be the first time we checked in on him all night, actually. We've seen him in different cuts, but this is the first time we've actually focused on him. Here we do our best to try and get through the field. And looks like Greer is just kind of on his own there. He's got Dimitrov just ahead. But for now, we're going to jump on board with the number 55 of Trent Nielsen. This is the first time we've checked in on him tonight. And again, we're just trying to get a position check on Nielsen out of Fort Wayne, Indiana. Sponsored by Nielsen Design and Photography. And we're just going to have to keep going on this one, I think. And now we're on board with the number 43 of Rafael De Los Santos. First time we checked in on him, and a little bit of contact between De Los Santos and Swint. Stamford, Connecticut Ford Mustang. Just going to stay on board with De Los Santos for another moment here as we try to get back up to the front of the field for the end of this one. And now we're back to our pole sitter, Ryan Gibson. At last check, he had been running in third place. It looks like he might be battling with Scott Bailey here. Indeed, this is a battle for second place. Here we see Scott Bailey up top, but it looks like Ryan Gibson might try and snag the position here. And Gibson runs high. We'll see if Bailey tries to get a run on him down low, but Gibson closes it off. And so with 10 laps remaining, Ryan Gibson takes second place. We're just going to hang around with Gibson here for a second. And we're going to stay in the same shot here for the moment as we are now on board with the number 9 of Jacob Nelson out of Clarksville, Tennessee. He had qualified second. Might not be the result he had hoped for to this point. And we'll just stay with him on the back straightaway, and then we will get to our race leader, I do believe, on our next check. It'll be the 41 of Jose Mercado, and we'll stay with him the rest of the way. And as we see Nelson cross the line here, now we are going to hop on board with the number 41 of Jose Mercado, who again is our leader. He's led basically untouched here through this third stage. And again, we saw this in the preseason when he took the win at Michigan. He just had an absolutely dominant car in the second stage of the race. And, you know, he was just able to pull away from the rest of the field. And you see the gap that he has on Gibson and Bailey, and he's got lap traffic between them. As we now have 7 laps remaining in this one. And lap traffic might be the only thing at this point that could keep Mercado from a victory if, you know, something was to happen on one of the straights or in the turns. And again, we'll have to see how Mercado's holding up as we're now on 6 laps remaining. As we see Mercado coming up to the start-finish line here shortly. Gonna take that low inside line. Nielsen being a good guy there and letting him by. And he's got 5 laps to go. Lap times to this point have been around 30, 31 seconds for our drivers to this point. See, the grass has been a bailout spot for a couple of our drivers this evening, as well as we see Mercado go low. 4 laps to go now. And oh, Mercado ran a little bit high there. I don't know if he made contact with the wall or not, but a little bit of a hairy situation there potentially, but crisis averted as Mercado goes down the straight. And into turn 3, coming through turn 4. Mercado, you see the pace he's got. He's just putting everybody else away. He's now got 3 laps remaining. And while we're with Mercado, let's... All right, I just accidentally pushed a button here, so we're going to do our best to get... So very sorry for the quick cuts here, ladies and gentlemen, but we're going to... get back to Jose Mercado. I can't just simply go backwards. Now we're on board with him. Let's try this again as he crosses the line again. I'm trying to change the camera angle. There we go. Now we're on board with Jose Mercado from the back. And he's into the back straightaway. Here, let's actually get onto the hood if we can. And I would not be shocked if we stay with this angle to potentially just take the white flag and the checkered in a couple laps time. And Mercado did indeed see the white flag that time around, so this is his final lap. Oh, a little bit of contact there between Mercado and De Los Santos. Those two have come together a couple of times throughout the season. But crisis avoided here as... looks like Mercado's going to hang on. Just coming through this last turn. And he's running a little high. You see the checkered flag this time around. Ladies and gentlemen, your winner, the number 41 Ford Mustang of Jose Mercado out of Kissimmee, Florida. With the victory, Mercado clinches his place in the Canadian eMotorsports Series playoffs. And he becomes the 6th different winner we've had over the course of this season. We're going to do our best to get our top 10 here. We've got a real quick picture. Jose Mercado is your winner. Ryan Gibson finishes second. Scott Bailey third. Jason Maluknik turns in his best performance of the season, finishing fourth. Shane Cannon is fifth. Darcy Ford was sixth. And we're just going to get the rest of the top 10 here as quickly as possible. All right, here we go. 7th place was Kevin Daigle in the... first of the two True North Racing Toyota Camrys, the number 13. He was followed by Mike Marini in the 42 right behind him. Jay Swint turns into top 10 finish, finishing 9th. And rounding out the top 10 is the number 63 of Bruce Webb. So, certainly a different looking top 10. It'll be interesting to see how things shake out here the rest of the way. We're heading to the Tricky Triangle next week. Hopefully this will be a... better production next time around for the Maritime Bus 175 Pocono Raceway next Tuesday night at 7:45 p.m. Eastern time for the pre-race. But for now, for CMS Race Control, Commissioner Daniel Cudmore, I'm Jordy Carraher. Have yourselves a wonderful night.